Welcome back everyone. Today's lesson is about torticollis. To start from the definition, torticollis is derived from the Latin tortus meaning twisted and collum meaning neck. Torticollis is a twisting of the neck that causes the head to rotate and tilt at an odd angle. Spasms of the sternocleidomastoid, trapezius and other neck muscles, usually more prominent on one side than the other, causes turning or tipping of the head. Torticollis is a common diagnosis and it estimates that 90% of individuals will exhibit at least one episode of torticollis throughout their lifetime. Typically, torticollis presents with abnormal rotation and flexion. However, there are several other positional presentations which might include flexion, extension, and right or left tilt. Torticollis might be benign, as in the case of congenital torticollis, or it might be malignant or due to serious causes such as brain injury. This is an image of a patient having different form of torticollis based on which type of muscles is affected. The first one is anterocollis, just to be pulled forward, and the second one is rotational collis, just to remain upright but to be turned, and the third is lateralcollis, sideways or toward either shoulder, and retrocollis is to be pulled backward. In general, torticollis is classified as either congenital muscular torticollis or acquired, which occurs during later infancy or childhood. By far, the most common type is congenital muscular torticollis. In the case of congenital muscular torticollis, although they have this when they are born, parents might not notice it until children are several weeks old, as they start to gain more control of their head movement. To discuss them separately, let us start congenital muscular torticollis. Congenital muscular torticollis is the most common cause of torticollis in the infant and the young children, and the median age at presentation and the diagnosis is around 2 months of age. The characteristic head tilt seen in this morphology or pathology is caused by abnormal contracture of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. With contracture of the muscle, the head tilts toward the involved side, with the chin rotated toward the opposite shoulder. Most often, this diagnosis is associated with breech or difficult deliveries, but might occur in uncomplicated spontaneous vaginal delivery or caesarean delivery. The deformity is most often present on the right side, and up to 20% of patients with congenital muscular torticollis will also have developmental dysplasia of the hip. So, consideration should be given to screening patients with congenital muscular torticollis for the developmental dysplasia of the hip with physical examination and imaging. Regarding epidemiology of congenital muscular torticollis, overall, the estimated incidence of congenital muscular torticollis is around less than 1% of all live births. The incidence might be as low as 0.3 in uncomplicated deliveries with vertex presentation or vertex position, or as high as 1.8 in patients with breech presentation. Regarding the clinical findings of congenital muscular torticollis, as you see on the image, the typical head posture results from the contracture of sternocleidomastoid muscle. The ear on the side of the contracture is tilted towards the ipsilateral shoulder, while the chin is rotated towards the contralateral shoulder. Occasionally, a firm mass or knot might be palpated in the sternocleidomastoid muscle, typically in a child less than 3 months of age. Due to the position when they sleep, plagiocephaly is commonly present on the side of the contracted sternocleidomastoid muscle and is related to the contracture. When we see imaging studies, the diagnosis of congenital muscular torticollis is primarily clinical. Every child with congenital muscular torticollis does not need imaging. However, they should be considered if the physical exam findings are not consistent with congenital muscular torticollis or if the deformity does not respond to conservative treatment. Ultrasound might be useful modality in the presence of palpable mass. Radiographs of the cervical spine might be obtained to rule out any associated congenital abnormalities. Regarding the etiology of congenital muscular torticollis, there are currently many theories regarding the etiology of congenital muscular torticollis. The first one is a birth trauma. Compression on the neck leads to venous compression of the sternocleidomastoid musculature. Ultimately, this results in compartment syndrome and the resultant fibrosis of the sternocleidomastoid musculature. The other is in utero crowding. This is supported by the fact that children with uncomplicated deliveries have congenital muscular torticollis. And also, it is supported by the association with other packaging, such as developmental dysplasia of the hip and metatarsus adductus. The other theory is about neurogenic myopathy. It says a combination of trauma and ischemia led to progressive fibrosis, which interrupts the sternocleidomastoid muscle branch of the spinal accessory nerve, and this nerve compression leads to contracture and a deformity. Regarding the treatment of congenital muscular torticollis, the mainstay of treatment is non-operative with manual stretching exercise, caregiver education, and environmental modification. The primary techniques of stretching the sternocleidomastoid muscle involves rotating the chin towards the ipsilateral shoulder while tilting the head towards the contralateral shoulder. Always, family education is very important, and most of them improves with this method. We should have to counsel the family to practice tummy time as much as they can while baby is awake and supervised. And when feeding their baby, offer the bottle or the breast from the side the baby does not normally like. And also during play time, place all toys on the side or he or she does not enjoy, and encourage him or her to turn his or her head by making noise or light, and carrying their child using different ways. And also they can sit their baby on their lap and by facing the child and showing him an object, and also minimizing time baby spends in sleeping position is very important. That constricts the infant's movement and cause prolonged pressure on the back of the head. So neck exercise is a very important thing that fixes these things. The range of motion and the cosmotic appearance is adequate in greater than 90% of patients following this treatment. And in patients with resistant pathology or who presents after 1 year of age, lengthening of sternocleidomastoid muscle might be considered by surgery. The other is about acquired torticollis. This is most common after the age of 6 months, and there is a limited range of motion in the head and the neck, and the head tilts to one side while the chin tilts to the other. With a condition called benign paroxysmal torticollis, there might be recurrent episodes or attacks of the head tilting. Often these attacks are accompanied by other symptoms such as vomiting, irritability, or drowsiness. Additional symptoms vary according to the cause of the torticollis. This is an image of a child having acquired torticollis. When we see the cause of acquired torticollis, this acquired torticollis might be caused by irritation to the cervical ligaments from a viral infection, injury, or vigorous movement. And also bacterial upper respiratory tract infections are also another common cause for acquired torticollis. Additional causes might include sleeping in awkward position, neck muscle injury at birth, an injury that causes heavy scarring and skin or muscle shrinkage like burn, and also neck muscle spasm. Regarding the treatment of acquired torticollis, treatment plan will vary based on the cause of the torticollis, and some common therapies include non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug to relieve pain and discomfort related to the musculoskeletal injury, antibiotic therapy for children whose torticollis is caused by infection, and medication to stop gastroesophageal reflex for children whose primary cause of torticollis is gastroesophageal reflex. This is a short summary about torticollis. Thank you for watching.